Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back. I made a video a long time ago talking about the history of Disney Springs and downtown Disney, what it used to be known, and it was once known as the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. And so I also had said a couple weeks back that I wanted to try out like a video series where I go to a certain place and I basically transport myself back to a certain time period. So say I go back to a certain year, Epcot in 1994, say like that. So today I wanted to try it for the first time. I'm over here at Disney Springs right now and I want to give this a try. So I'm going to transport myself back in the day, back to 1976, back to when this place was known as the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. And of course, I'd say if you haven't seen my History of Disney Springs video, go ahead and check that out first. I'll leave a link in the description below, and then come back to this video so that you get a better understanding of everything about this place. And thank you to Retro WDW and Walt Dated World. I'm using both of their websites right now to help me film this video. I'll leave links to both of their websites down below as well. All right, so we have been transported to 1976 here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. And right over here, as soon as we enter, over here to the right, this would have been the post office over here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. And as we move on from the post office right here, we would come over here to the right, and this building right here was known as Village Spirits. And over here in the Village Spirits, you would actually be able to sample wine and taste different beers and spirits from all around the world. And then as we continue down from the Village Spirits, we would come up on this store with a weird name. It was called the Apothecary. And today this is known as the Art of Disney. And it's actually a pretty big store. But back in 1976, when this was known as the Apothecary, you could buy a whole bunch of different things in here. It was basically like a general store, kind of. Different types of cosmetics. You could buy film and things for your camera in here, as well as get some books or some magazines. All right, let's head back here, back to where the post office was, because we got to talk about this other side over here. So today, this right here is one big store known as the Days of Christmas. But back in 1976, right here, this store used to be called Michael's. And this right here was actually a barbershop which offered haircuts and manicures for men. And just a fun fact, Michael's was actually the only store here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village that would be closed on Sundays. As we make our way right here down from Michael's, we would come upon a store right here, and it was called Plus U. It actually didn't sell any plus size clothing or anything like that. This was actually just an accessory store. And right here next to Plus U, you would actually find your first clothing store. It was right here. It was called Miss Merrily's Madness. And they would actually specialize in selling young women's clothing. And then right next to that store, we would have our final store over here on the left. This was actually known as the Flower Garden. And just as the name says, this place would sell any types of flowers. Yeah, artificial flowers, real flowers. And that actually completes this whole front area where I just walked in, both the left and the right side. It's kind of cool to see how the buildings are actually like still separated by what they were in the past. Like, this is the post office and now it's just part of this wonderful world of memories right here, but it still looks different. And then on this side we would have the Michael's shop right here, and it's kind of different from what this area Plus U would be, and then from where this clothing store would be, and then finally down at the garden, Flower Garden over there. And as we continue our way down this way, we would run into a store right about over here, and it was known as 24KT Precious Adornments. And basically it just sells jewelry. That's what this store was for, just to sell jewelry. Okay, so right here next to the 24KT jewelry store, right here is Goofy's Candy Co. today, but back in 1976, this would have been Carolyn's Couture. Actual designers would come over here and make appearances, and actually a lady known as Lily Pulitzer designed a collection for this store, and that was actually the second time that she had designed anything for anybody ever. And the first time was actually for the King of Morocco. So Disney and the King of Morocco are apparently the only two worthy people for this lady. It seems like there used to be some kind of connection between these two buildings right here. I don't know if it was just a roof right here or if it was an actual building right here, but there was definitely some type of connection. Anyways, we would cross into over here and we would turn right here where you see the Rainforest Cafe today. And this was actually known as the Village Restaurant. It was basically a two-tiered restaurant which had overlooking views of Lake Buena Vista right back over here. And just a fun fact, actually this restaurant right here, after it was the Village Restaurant, it became Chef Mickey's, which you might know from today as being over at the Contemporary. And as we continue past the Village Restaurant, we would make our way to another famous restaurant over here at the Village. Right around this area right here is where a restaurant was. It was called Captain Jack's Oyster Bar. This was a very popular restaurant and it actually sticked around for a very, very long time. It just closed in 2013. And that restaurant was actually named after Disney legend Jack Olson, and I talk about that more in my history of the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village video. But before you could actually head over here into Captain Jack's Oyster Bar, you actually had to pass through a store which was right around this area. It was known as Windjammer's Dock Shop, and it actually sold some swimwear and some other nautical items. And just as we passed Captain Jack's Oyster Bar, we would turn like this and we would come up on three different stores that would be on this side. The first store would have been right here, and it was known as the Country Address, and it was another clothing store just for women. And located next to the Country Address was a shop right here. It was called the It's a Small World After All shop, and it basically featured some kids clothing, and they could also come over here and buy some Disney plushes and some other little Disney souvenirs like that. And next to that shop was actually a pet store. It was right here. Yeah, there was a pet store right here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. It was called Posh Pets, and you could actually buy real live animals here. They actually had an albino skunk at one time. But you can actually come over here and get any of your pet accessories as well as you can come over here and book an appointment for your pet to get groomed. Posh Pets was one of the stores that actually closed very early on in the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village life. It closed in October of 1976. And I don't know if it was on accident or on purpose, but right here is where the Posh Pets store used to be. And today, in 2019, there's a little stand right here called Happy Hound where you can buy any of your dog's necessities. You got like leashes, toys, you got some dog biscuits. So it's kind of ironic how 40 plus years later, there's another pet store here at the same location, basically just feet away from where the old one was. And right here next to where Posh Pets was this place right here, and it was called Captain's Tower. This was basically a space where special events at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village were held. Actually, in 1977, Darth Vader came over here and he was actually seen in this little place. And during Christmas time, they would place light up reindeer all around here. And right here, as you see, which is the Earl of Sandwich right now, this used to be known as the Gourmet Pantry. This is where you could stock up on all kinds of delicacies from all over the world. Right next to it, this used to be known as the Candy Factory, and you could actually come over here and look into the windows, kind of like you can now over on some of the parts in Disney Springs as well as in the different theme parks. You could look in here and see actual candy being made by the candy makers. And just across from the Candy Factory right here, we would have a toy store right here and another food stop right here. The toy store right here was called Toys Fantastic, and it actually had very high quality toys for back in the day. They had toys ranging from Briar Horses, Madame Alexandra dolls, and teddy bears made from mink fur. Now, I'm not sure if they sold any Disney specific toys in here, but they did have some pretty high quality toys. And over here, after you're done shopping for your toys, you can come grab a bite to eat at Heidelberger's Deli. And this place has supposedly had the biggest burgers over here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. They said they had palm stretching burgers. All right, and at this point, we have basically covered everything here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village from this point all the way forward. And now we have to focus just on a few more things over here. And just right here, besides the Captain's Tower, we would actually have two different shops over here. Right here, we would have Sir Edward's Haberdasher, which basically sold men's clothing. This was basically a shop for men. And then it was connected to this shop right here, which was known as Von Otto's Antiques. And this shop was actually like a theme shop. It actually had a backstory to it. It was said that Otto Rabi was an antique buyer for Old World Antiques in the Magic Kingdom. And he was actually stocking this shop with such items such as mahogany children's books, gilt edge mirrors, and grandfather clocks. And then just as we pass that shop, we would come over here where we could find a bath parlor. And right here, basically, you could get all of your bath necessities. And also, in the back of the shop, we can't go back there right now, but you used to be able to walk behind there. There actually was a shop called Pipe Dream, where you could get all of your smoking necessities. You could buy a new pipe to smoke all your tobacco, if that was what you wanted. Because as we know, back then, smoking tobacco was very common. It was normal practice, and there was a lot of tobacco shops in Disney parks. And maybe once you were done buying all your pipes and tobacco, you would come over here into this area, which was a shop called Kane Wicker Ratton and Sons, where you could find wicker rickshaw, rattan gazebos, or a cane-backed rocking chair. And this is just one of those instances where there was shops all the way down like this. And next to that shop was a watchmaker, and then next to that was a place called Colonnade des Arts. And next to that art store was another art store called Toledo Arts, where craftsmen were usually on hand to demonstrate work, where they would etch metal with acid and add gold or silver. And just as I've seen in pretty much every Disney park ever, there's always like a crystal shop. And right here was also another crystal shop, and it was called Crystal Arts. And over here, you can actually observe the artists at work while they are carving their crystals. Then finally, on this long strip of shops right here, we would finally come to this place right here, which was called 2R's, also known as Read and Writin'. It was basically a card shop. It actually sold some party supplies and some books. And then on the other side of all of these shops right here that I just mentioned, this whole row of shops was actually known as the Port of Entry. And the Port of Entry was a cool shop which actually featured items from all around the world. It was basically a Epcot shop before there was Epcot. And then you're probably getting a little bit hungry at this point, so we would come right over here into a little restaurant called Light Bite. And it actually wasn't a place where you could get light food, maybe some healthy food. This was actually a fast food restaurant, basic fast food that you would find around any theme park. So that brings us to our final area, which is right here. Right in this area right here was known as the Chalet Candle Shop, and guests could actually come over here and witness craftsmen hand make different types of candles. Actually, right next to the Chalet Candle Shop was the Pottery Chalet. The Pottery Chalet would be right over here in this area, and guests could actually come over here and watch as pottery would be made. A cool little fact is that the Pottery Chalet was actually the largest shop at the village. Then right here we come to our last shop, the last anything at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village in 1976, and this right here was known as the Anniversary Room. The Anniversary Room sold different types of china, silverware, and giftware. And guys, that is it. I hope you enjoyed traveling back to 1976 with me here at the Lake Buena Vista Shopping Village. I had an awesome time coming over here and looking at all of the old things that used to be here. If you guys are interested, pretty much this whole marketplace used to be here, besides that over there where the Once Upon a Time and the Void and the Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique are. Pretty much everything else was here. You can tell because the buildings all look the same. They all have these certain roofs. But yeah, man, let me know if you guys would like to see more of these videos from around Disney Springs, from around the different parks, maybe even the hotels, maybe. Also, I'll do these at Universal as well. So let me know if you like it or not. Just go ahead and give the video a like. Comment down below any suggestions. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys very much for watching. It's kind of fun to do the impossible, and I'll see you guys on the next video.